drop their temperature just as rapidly as a child in a newborn nursery. So find that bathing without a bath. Watch about the towel bath several times. The key to bathing a hospice patient, especially in bed, is the no rinse, you know, the no rinse soap, the no rinse shampoo, or the shower in a cap. You know, making the experience as less physical distressing for these folks as we can. Changing their gowning sheets often is really imperative. A lot of times, as death nears, they will perspire more and more and more. And that will just make the bed linens colder and colder and colder. So a lot of times changing them is a way of keeping them from getting so cold. Something very simple we can do for all of our clients is when we turn them, is just simply flip the pillow over. You know, they've been on this side of the pillow for about 2 hours, breathing into it. It's hot, it's muggy. Flip it over to the other side. Give them the cool, crisp side. Now, if you ever do have a hospice client that is really, really, really cold, and if you can do this, if this is allowable, with a bath blanket, pop it in a microwave for a very, very, very short time. Don't put it in too long or catch it on fire, of course, but a very short time. And then put the warm bath blanket right against them. Don't lay it on top of them, but put it underneath the covers and have the warm bath blanket right against them. It will help them a lot. Oral care frequently. You know, because like I said, as they're a mouth breather and they have oxygen on, the inside of their mouth is going to become incredibly dry. It can be cracked. You know, you may have before had a canker sore in your mouth, so you know how bad that can hurt sometimes. Well, same thing is here. With a dry mouth, a cracking lip, a cracking tongue can cause a lot of distress. Ice chips are great. Head of the bed up though, not a flattened bed of course, and make sure they can swallow thin fluids. You know, if they've gotten to the point where the epiglottis is not closing well enough and you've had to put them on, you know, the doctor ordered, the case manager, you know, thickened liquids, well, ice chips are not going to work anymore because they're going to melt in the mouth and go as a thin liquid as they swallow, and then, of course, aspiration. If they haven't reached that point yet, ice chips do help a lot. A lot of folks that are nauseated, that are dying because they have the nausea feeling, cold beverages, cold foods seem to diminish the feeling of nausea. Lubricating the mouth and nose is really, really imperative. Again, like I was saying, because it cracks, the lips crack, the inside of the mouth cracks. Now, pain control and comfort is probably the foremost goal of hospice. Watch them for pain. One of the things that your hospice may have talked about or you may hear is called the FLACC system, F-L-A-C-C. It stands for face, legs, activity, crying, consolability. Now, if your client is alert and oriented and can answer this question, then by all means, ask them. You know, George, on a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being the most severe pain you've ever had in your life before, how would you rate your pain today? And if George says anything like 1, 2, or 3, well, that's mild. 4, 5, or 6 is moderate. 7, 8, 9, 10, of course, is severe. Well, what happens if George is confused, has some cognitive deficits, or is even in a coma? That's where the FLACC, FLACC system, comes in. Face. Because if somebody's in pain, you can tell it on their face. They're grimacing, they're frowning, they're maybe biting their lips. The muscles in the cheeks are really hard and not soft, you know. You can tell it by their face. The L stands for legs. And if you've been in pain yourself, you know that you just can't hold your leg still. You're moving it, you're flexing it, you're rotating it here, you're squirming all around with your legs. And not only your legs, but your whole body, your upper body, your activity, your banking.